she's up against Adriana Diaz of Puerto Rico.
Yeah, and the strapping on Monica's right leg, it's right below the knee. I find it a very different place, right? It's not on the knee, it's not the calf. I wonder what's wrong.
You've been an athlete, an Olympian. What is that tape for?
So these tapes actually helps. And this is called table tennis at its best. The speed and the spin and the placement is absolutely berserk, both backhand and forehand side. Women's table tennis, you bet, is at the best.
I've always just thought, what is that tape? How can the external tape make a difference to an internal injury?
So the tape helps in actually giving good support to the most spasm part, which is there on your leg or the part of your body. So the external tape, it's so tight that it holds the muscle firm for that particular time so that you can sustain the match and go through.
I see. And as a taller player, it can be difficult. You've got to bend more, longer levers, more likely to get injuries such as tennis elbow or bad hips and knees. And we see Sofia Polkanova actually also with a bandage she's had over her knee for some time as a tall player in the women's game. There's that punch, Amanda Nunes. One
it's
punch
like
knockout.
A slap right there.
It's like, take that. Twiddling in a split second, fiddling with the ball, Monica Batra. She really does have a unique style. And Diaz is going to have a keen eye on what kind of balls are coming her way because they are ever changing.
Mm-hmm. And if you're just joining us and are new to the sport of table tennis, the red side of Monica's racket is the long pimple rubber, and what it does is produce the exact opposite spin as what the opponent is giving to you, bringing in a lot of surprises.
Oh, ow. They don't come back. Let's just say that.
That was lethal, Fraser.
Here we go. Batra might as well not have even bothered.
And that's very high pressure for Batra out there because she's trying to find answers as to how do I try to produce the maximum surprise from my rubber to Adriana Diaz. Adriana is way too comfortable playing against those long pips.
She is, and she's beaten players such as Polkanova before, Ekholm, Shibata.
Lovely. That opening from the long pimples is very, very low to the net. It kind of floats, and you have to generate a lot of spin from your core. If you're not in the position, it's not going to come back.
Slow one there from Diaz. High and slow, just giving Batra a different level of trajectory. And that was effective against the long pippies.
Very effective, Fraser, you rightly mentioned. Only if she can change this trajectory very often, no spin and underspin very often, she can stay in the game.
Cam, but she's going to have to serve tighter than that if she wants to stay in this game. Diaz, 7-8, pendulum into middle. Ooh, got away with that, didn't she? Two siblings who also play. Her father is her coach, have a center in Puerto Rico. Daddy Diaz is doing great things.
That was a good long serve with back with a lot of backspin yet side spin, which probably Diaz was not expecting. She went inside the table, guessing it wrong.
And again, Batra also likes a punch. This is a fist fight, and it's 10-8. Two Manika fighting here on home soil with hundreds of Indians pouring in here to this arena. A table tennis fan in India, you've got to make the trip here to Goa.
No.
Batra doesn't want a trip here. 10-9. 9-10. Diaz, what will she try and muster? Will she go long or will she keep it tight? She goes kind of tight. There we go. And that is the difference maker to what she used to be like.
Second game, Diaz to serve.
Adriana Diaz, the South American star, studded superstar. She did get drawn into a few cross-court rallies, backhand to backhand, and she has a stronger forehand than Manika. So she's going to try and get that in first, I think, to the forehand.
Although to me, the real strategy to play against somebody with the long pimples is to keep playing on the backhand side to the long pimples.
Okay.
Yeah.
It depends what kind of forehands Diaz wants to play. Because at the end of the day, playing into the forehand of Manika, you're getting a more predictable ball back. Whereas Batra can play three different types of spins from the backhand side. And Diaz definitely doesn't want to become exhausted having to lift backspin after she's played a good topspin. But there she does win it back onto backhand. It depends how long she's willing to rally. I think that's the key factor.
Yeah, and I'm smiling to myself thinking Manika's come to this tournament not having her nails painted. And Adriana Diaz has the silver one, and Manika's nails have been doing the rounds since quite a few years. Which she comes in with the Indian flag mostly on them. Absolutely insane! That was a beautiful punch from Adriana Diaz. It felt like she knew it and so comfortable. Boom, it was down the line like a slap. Let me show you what I'm made of.
You think she has short pips on the backhand, the way she punches sometimes. But she doesn't. She's able to use the inverted rubber to do that. After clipping the edge. It's a cheeky one. 2-5. To infinity and beyond.
I love how Diaz has increased the pace from the backhand side. And that is traditionally her strong point.
Well, Batra there.
Gotta be patient.
Sunil, who I commentated with yesterday, made a good point. Batra's style is fantastic, really, really effective and advantageous against someone who doesn't know it well. But as soon as you're up against people who do know it well, it's no longer an advantage.
Yeah, I also feel that's a very early sort of analysis, right? Somebody who's world number 34 at Manika's level, you cannot expect the opponents to not understand your style of play. And you got to always be ready with other options and pack your game very well.
Yeah. A style inspired by yourself.
I tell you, the long pips is not easy to learn. I call it an art because sometimes what the rubber does, what sort of effect it produces, you don't know yourself. And thus you need to be super creative to just control this rubber. And players with long pimples have the maximum sort of weapons in their kitty.
When I was commentating last weekend in Switzerland at the European Top 16, whoa, it's like a pinball machine.
You cannot win Manika in this game. The moment you increase the speed, she becomes very, very comfortable. She's trained immensely for this forehand smash by her coach at all levels. The forehand smash she did is the bread and butter for a long pimples player, and she does it so well. I love it.
She's going way too much into the backhand side, though, Diaz. I know she won the point, but she's making life very difficult for herself. She's a player capable to step the corner and play a bomb down the line.
And that's exactly, Fraser, she needs to do if she wants to irritate Manika, because if you keep giving deep into the backhand, you're not allowing her to step around, which she loves.
Yep. Diaz, as we said, has the better forehand. She needs to make more use of it. Play into the forehand of Batra, so Diaz is basically facing something she's more accustomed to. Oh.
Luck favors the brave.
Well, that is gonna hurt Adriana Diaz.
And you could see the change in the body language as well.
Snatching at that just a tad. She escapes Batra.
Yeah, that was erratic. That was not what Adriana Diaz would generally do with a calm mind. I'm sure she is regretting that. You look at that. Backhand slow. She was way too early on the table. She should have paused just for a slight second before hitting that forehand.
Looks like a training drill, but Batra pivots. And Batra definitely has the belief. Whoa. Chops from away from the table from Batra. That is magic.
And speaking of belief, Fraser, trust me, none of the Indian girls, say 5 or 6 years back, ever believed that they could be top in the world. And Manika has changed that. She's shown what can be done. And that Indians are here to stay. Beautiful by Manika.
Every path ever walked down by a man or woman has been paved by another previously. And Manika is the one brave enough to step into the deep waters of world table tennis. Transfer from Diaz, some gasps from the crowd, but she'll be thinking, why the heck didn't I do that sooner?
Yeah, and if she wants to stay in the game, she has to. She does not want to get into long rallies with Manika. If you noticed, most of the long rallies have been won by Manika. So you got to make her uncomfortable and finish the rally quick.
I know the Indian fans don't want to hear this tuning in, but I really think Adriana Diaz is going to come back into this. I've got a feeling, especially if she doesn't get drawn into Batra's game. Like you say, going backhand to backhand too much. Oh, the chop block, and then she was almost kerfuffled with her own spin coming back. Batra will reverse what you give her. So the key is to give her not what you want the first time, to get what you want the second time.
Yeah, and what Manika did right there, the slow backhand, it is not easy, because generally the tendency of the ball is to slide long and away from the table.
Yeah, she's coming in with the heat now, Diaz. It's a good match. It's a nice clash of styles. But the Indians don't want to see it going any longer than needs be.
Ooh, yeah, everyone wants Manika to be there.
Yeah.
She is the Indian heroine. She has also been conferred with the highest sporting honor by the Indian government, which is the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. What an honor for an Indian table tennis player to get in India.
Is this an award that comes from trying to really give back to the communities, build up schools, help the grassroots of the sport? What kind of award is that?
It is for your achievements in the sport, and Manika winning gold medals at the 2018 Commonwealth Games was so marvelous.
Whoa!
Where did that come from? It was not out there. It was towards the backside, right? Adriana Diaz, if we can look at again.
Let's have a look at the stroke. Ooh.
She's kind of pulling the backhand back.
Yeah.
And Adriana Diaz has got the trick, Fraser. If she can stick on this strategy, Indian fans could be disappointed.
Huge potential. I just feel it in the blooming air. Honestly. Diaz can come back. Vatra looks like she knows that. Because she's playing so much tactically better now, Diaz. And if Diaz is playing this way, with her style, Vatra, she's limited as to what she can do. Look at these fans. They're shaking their head. Oh.
And I now sense some sort of disappointment in Manika. It was a good towel break for her to calm her nerves down, to stay focused and stay calm.
Oh, double devastation. A net edge. Switch there from Batra.
And learning how to twiddle, how to switch, is so hard, Fraser, to be able to do in the middle of the rally. You have to practice it a lot.
This is Adriana Diaz, and this is why she has been and really is a top 10 world level player, because she's capable of shots like this. Unparalleled power there in the end. Can she come up with some more magic here? The Puerto Rican princess. She's up against the golden girl of India.
And that's first time I saw serve and stepping around for the forehand on the third ball attack.
Ooh, it was nice change there. Down the line into the middle. Batra, very, very tall player for a women's player. And that's a good area to hit into, isn't it?
Just see if I can see that in slow-mo, that rally. You can see the type of changes in positioning Manika did. She served from the forehand, went to the backhand side, and then stepped around from backhand.
Ooh. Batra came through a ball that had no spin on it whatsoever, and she went long. She relies on her opponent's spin in many ways, Batra.
And thus the trick is to give a no spin and then a huge underspin.
And Jay Hume would have done okay against her. I think with those bluff forehands he did against Patrick Franziska earlier, can Diaz do the same? Well, look what we have here. Tension here at the Mukherjee Stadium, named after the political leader and freedom fighter.
And a lot of Indian fans must be following Manika Batra. She's got a huge following on her Instagram, Twitter, all social media accounts. 2-5. She was the first ever Indian female table tennis player to win a medal at the Asia Cup last year.
Guess who she beat there? Second seed here. Hina Hayata, who is out.
Well, Manika has had many firsts to herself. She, in 2018 Commonwealth Games, she also became the first woman ever to, Indian woman, to win two gold medals in a singles and in teams. There she beat Fang Tai Wei in the finals or the semis, I don't recall, but it was either. And that was one of the huge victories for her career so far.
In and out of the table from Diaz, and eventually she went for a dismissive slap. She'd had enough. She wanted to just deal the point ender.
And you see how calm Manika is and how annoyed Diaz is getting. You can see it in the strokes.
She's getting drawn into these rallies again, and Batra will win this match unless Diaz initiates her own influence onto these rallies, which is going to have to come from that big old forearm that she has. Oh, it sat up for her, but she missed it. That's a gift for Batra, because that one probably wouldn't have come back. Perhaps Diaz just had to take 10-15% off that. Batra was already away from the table, so no need to try and play too big of a shot there from Diaz.
Yeah, I do see this slipping away from Diaz because of the mental pressure.
Shovel serve. Spin down the line, and she misses another sitter.
She is not happy with the long pips. She is not happy with how Manika is just playing like a wall. She's giving back every single thing Adriana Diaz has to offer tonight.
Black forehand, it comes back. Diaz survives. That is incredible play. Diaz showcasing her quality away from the table, but she was in no woman's land back there. Batra there playing a lovely block cross court. There's already so much pace on the ball. No need to create her own. Not over yet though. Not over yet. We haven't seen a Batra timeout, have we? I don't think so.
Yeah. I reckon if it goes to 9-7, the coach might call for a timeout.
Oh, and it has gone 9-7.
That was brutal.
Yeah.
And that kind of hurts, right? I mean, those are the things you don't want to receive from an opponent. Look at that tight slap on the extreme back, and no chance.
Up the line she goes. She switched it up. She switched it on. That's a phenomenal push. Wasn't showing where she was going. Not slowing and showing. Manika Batra is two away from going into the round of 16.
And that's exactly what the coach told her with the action. And Manika is beautiful in executing what the coach tells her.
Batra is into the round of 16. The Indian dream continues here.